ओम सर्व वेदांत सिद्धांत गोचरं तम गोचरं गोविंदं परमानंदं सद्गुरुं प्रणतोस्मि हम। वी हैव बीन ट्राइंग टू स्टडी श्री शंकराचार्य विवेक चूड़ामणि एंड वी हैव स्टडीड अप टू श्लोक 96 लास्ट टाइम एंड द टॉपिक गोइंग ऑन इज डिस्क्रिमिनेशन and within that the sub topic is about the sukshma sharir, linga sharir or subtle body. Up to, we have seen that up to 91, the gross body was described in such a way that we can easily discriminate it is not myself. Now, after, from 92 onwards, the subtle body is being described, and in the 96 shloka we had seen that it consists of five organs of action, five organs of knowledge, five pranas, five elements. And buddhi and ajnana, desire and action. So these are eight cities make up what is called the subtle body. पुरी अष्टकम सूक्ष्म शरीरम आहु। पुरी मीन्स टाउन सिटी। सो एट टाइप ऑफ सिटीज, एट टाइप ऑफ ग्रुप ऑफ थिंग्स। नाउ वी कम टू 97। इदम शरीरम श्रुणु सूक्ष्म संगीतम लिंगम तु अपंचीकृत भूत सम्भवम सवासनम कर्म फलानुभावकम स्वाज्ञानतो नादिरुपाधिरात्मना। लेट अस थिंक वर्ड बाय वर्ड। इदम शरीरम दिस बॉडी विच हैज बीन डिस्क्राइब्ड अप टिल नाउ, श्रुणु लिसन फ्रॉम मी, इज कॉल्ड एज सूक्ष्म सटल। दैट मीन्स विच यू कैनॉट परसीव बाय अवर ऑर्गन, दैट इज कॉल्ड सटल। इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड लिंगम, दिस वन हैज टू अंडरस्टैंड। लिंगम इज the sign, sign, the, in Hindi we say pehchan, how to recognize a person. We cannot just recognize a person by how he looks, but what is his character, what is his mental trait, so that it is called linga sharir. That a person exists is not known only because of the outer body, external body, but the type of the mind, type of the indriyas, type of this digestive function, all this taken into consideration to understand what a man is. And so it is called linga sharir. Linga means the sign, the characteristics of his personality. So lingam tu. Tu is but lingam. That means who is in comparison with the gross body, where we are told that the five elements, when they compound, they become gross, and then we get the gross body. So, but this subtle body or linga sharir is apanchikruta bhuta sambhavam. Apanchikruta, uncombined. The elements in themselves, that which induces sound and give space for objects to live, that is called akasha in itself, without being combined with other elements. This cannot be recognized, this cannot be seen by our indriyas, but the yogis can see, the rishis can see, those whose perception has become subtler, they can see, and they have given out all these formulations to us. It is not just built up, as they say, speculative philosophy or some hypothetical knowledge. It is direct knowledge of the rishis, though we cannot pursue, but the people with subtler perception, they can pursue. So they say it is uncombined elements in themselves. The vayu is a slight classification of akasha. So vayu adds one more quality. Along with the sound, it has the touch quality also, but no other quality, and it stands itself. without being combined with the other elements. Teja adds one more quality that is called rupa, or seeing. We can see because it is light. So shabda, sparsha, rupa are there, but it is not combined. So it is in itself, can be pursued by the yogis. And then come the apa. Now they never meant these gross things as we see, but the subtle elements given these names because the qualities are associated with these. We know that apa generates taste. We know that teja generates vision. We know that vayu generates sparsha, and akasha generates sound, and prithvi generates smell. We know that. So the original elements which are not gross as yet are also given the same names because of the same characteristics. So that is the linga sharir is what the apanchikruta bhuta sambhavam, made of the apanchikruta uncombined elements, bhuta matter elements. So asanam. But vasanam has two meanings, the original and the derived. Original meaning is impressions. These subtle elements making up the mind and the indriyas, they can retain impressions. We see something in the gross, in the waking state, and the impression is carried to our mind and it stays there. That gives rise to desires. So vasana means desire is the secondary meaning. The original meaning of vasana is impression. So, savasanam, this linga sharir carries with it the impressions of what we observed in the waking state. Karma phala anubhavata. And it gives us, soul body was told, the house where we enjoy things. But sushma sharir is the cause of that enjoyment. We can experience only through our indriyas and mind. So we cannot see our indriyas or mind, but through our indriyas or mind, we experience the objects. And so, and where from do we get these objects? The spiritual law tells us, not again a speculation, not through reason, but the through Rishi's vision we know that as we have done in the past life, or as we are doing now, the fruit or the result is our happiness or misery. And that happiness or misery or all the other feelings are experienced through these subtle organs. Experiences of the soul, but the experience is generated through these subtle elements. So, karma phala anubhavakam, that which causes the experience of the karma phala, good or bad, that is through this sukshma sharira. Swajnanato, we have wrong knowledge. Ajnana is wrong knowledge always. We have wrong knowledge about ourselves. Because we have wrong knowledge about ourselves, therefore, anadi upadhi ratmana. When it has started, can we tell? When this anubhava started, which life it has started, which is the first life, there is no such thing. It moves in cycles. As in our dream, we do not know when that has started. We find ourselves in the dream. Similarly, the situation about this subtle body, because of our wrong knowledge about ourselves, beginningless time, time itself begins together with our subtle body. In deep sleep, can we know the time? In samadhi, can we know the time? We know the time only when we get up and look at the watch. So, in dream, the time is different type. So, anadi, the time scale starts only in the subtle body. Upadhi ratmana. What is upadhi? It is not Atman, but it is taken to be Atman, so it is called upadhi, the limiting adjuncts of the Atman. But By limiting adjunct will not understand thing, though that is the word. So I explained that that which is not Atman but is taken as Atman, that is called Upadhi. So Atmana Upadhi. Instead of Atman, we are taking this as Atman. So it is the Upadhi of the Atman. It is the limiting adjunct which defines a jiva. So it is a Upadhi of the Atman. So he has described the subtle body in such a way that we understand that it is not the self. First of all, it is matter. This body called the Sushma or Linga, it is made of subtle form of matter. It contains the impressions. They give rise to karma phala experience to us. And because of our wrong knowledge about ourselves, timeless, without beginning as it is there, and it is limiting adjunct of the Atman, that means it is taken in place of Atman, that is how it is not Atman. Svapno bhavatyasya vivaktyavastha svamatra sheshena vivati yatra svapne tu buddhi swayameva jagrat kalina nana vidavasanavi कर्तरादि भावं प्रतिपद्य राजते यत्र स्वयं भाति अयं परात्मा धीमात्र कोपादि अशेष साक्षी धीमात्र कोपादि अशेष साक्षी न लिप्यते तत्कृत कर्मलेश यस्माद् असंगस्तत एव कर्मवीर न लिप्यते किंचित उपाधि न कृतै. टू श्लोकस वेर टुगेदर एक्चुअली 10 lines were read together, because the sentence becomes complete there. It gives out the meaning there. So, Svapna, dream, Bhavati becomes Asya Vibhakti Avastha. Vibhakti means separate than Jagruti. The expression, the state of Svapna becomes Asya. That means the subtle body can be recognized in dream. When the dream state comes, our gross body is not functioning, it is sleeping. Our indriyas are not functioning, they are sleeping. So what is functioning? The subtle body. So it's a special vivakti avastha, that means it's specially expressed avastha is dream. And what happens there? So matra sheshena. In the waking state, it has gathered some experiences. And the remainder of that, that means by experience it has gone. But the impression remains. That much impression remains. So matra sheshena. The remaining impressions, vivati yatra, with the help of that impressions, it is experienced in the dream state. So dream state is the experience of the impressions gathered in the waking state, and that defines our dream. Buddhi here. Buddhi here stands for the mind itself. Huh? Buddhi here, svapnetu, in buddhi, swayameva, jagrat kali, that very thing is described, jagrat kalina vasana, Jagrat Kalina Nana Vida Vasana. So in the waking state, hundreds and thousands of impressions we gather. And those impressions of different types, Nana Vida of different types, Vasana Vi, through those impressions, Swayameva Buddhi Vibhati, connected with the previous line. So the mind itself, there are no objects in the dream. Mind itself, with the help of impressions, creates a subject and objects, and we experience them. That is the dream state. In the dream state, suppose I am eating a mango. That mango is made by my mind, and that I who is eating the mango is also made by my mind, because I am sleeping. So, through the impressions gathered in the waking state, the mind itself becomes divided, subject and object, And that is how we experience the dream state. But there are things then. In the subtle body, there is the kartra adibhavam. I am the doer. This idea, this consciousness belongs to the subtle body. Gross body, we know, is a material thing. But where this I am idea, I am doer, idea retains in the subtle body. Kartradi. Kartradi means I am the enjoyer. I am the doer, I am the experiencer, is experienced in the subtle body. Kartradi bhavam pratipadya. Pratipadya means it asserts. The subtle body asserts, I am the doer, I am the enjoyer. Rajate shines. Shines, expresses, manifests through, I am the doer and I am the experiencer, this subtle body. Yatra swayam bhati ayam paratma. Ayam paratma, this, the transcendent self, this, the real self of man. No discrimination is being shown. This real self of the man, the ultimate self of the man, itself is the source of light. Important thing, now we see a cinema show. Figures are going on on the screen. How do they appear real to us? Because of the focused light which is falling on them. In the waking state, we use the external light and our eyes to see things. Now in dream, same experience is going on mind, whether imaginary or whatever, but we are seeing, we are hearing, we are touching, we are having all the experiences. So from where this light comes, Atman is called Swayam Jyoti. The Atman has its own light. And this, with the help of this light, the experience of the impressions is going on. Very critically is analyzing the subtle body and telling us that the experience in the dream state, I am Paratma Swayam Bhati, its own light of the transcendent self that is shining there. Sunlight is not reaching there. Tube light is not reaching there. Fire is not reaching there. Lightning is not reaching there. Moon, stars are not reaching there. And yet we see this is through the light of the Atman, which itself is shining. The Matraka Upadhi Ashesha Sakshi. The Matraka Upadhi, about the ultimate self is being told. What is the Upadhi there? The mind itself. Mind itself is the taken as myself, not the body. So the Matraka Upadhi, Ashesha Sakshi, and he experiences. He is the ultimate witness, he is called Sakshi because he does not change. And no change in him, but the impressions are being experienced by him through the buddhi. Being identified with the buddhi as it is I am this buddhi. And through that, he experiences all the subtle objects by its own light. And it does not change. Na lipyate tat kruta karmaleshi. Now, what we do in dream, it is not affected by that. The self is not affected by anything done in dream. It is only experience. This another important thing, the Puranas may tell anything. Puranas tell us that Harishchandra donated Vishwamitra in his dream. We do not know what it signifies. But if we do some bad thing in the dream. Suppose you have stolen something. will not be punished for that in the waking state. We may have done some good act in the dream, that will not get the result in the waking state. So, na lipyate tat kruta karma leshai. Whatever tat krutam is, Atman through the upadhi of the mind, if it has done something in the dream state, it's like the jagruti, we do something and we experience the fruit in the dream state or later on in the jagruti itself. But like that, this is an important thing, that whatever we do in the dream state, we are not liable to be rewarded or punished for that. It is only an experience. It is only the instincts are released. It is only the impressions which are seen. Dhimatraka upadhi, Atman is only the witness. It does not change. And it does not change. Itself is described in this way, that it does not have to undergo the fruits of what it has done in the dream state. Na lipyate tat kruta karma leshe, not even a slight tinge, karma lesh, even the slightest tinge of the karmas done in the dream state do not bind a man or do not give him any fruit or result, so he is not attached to that. He comes out of that. When we come out of the dream state, are we attached to the things in the dream state? No. Whatever we have done in the dream vanishes in the dream. In the daytime, we are not attached by that. Yasmad asangaha, because it is asanga. The very nature of Atman is one without a second. There is nothing else other than Atman. Atman is not a subject to be attached to objects. That is clearly perceived in the dream state. So because it is asanga by nature, because Atman is asanga, unattached by nature, tateva karma bir nalipyate. So, in the waking state also, from that we remember that we do some karma, and because of the wrong knowledge, because of the upadhi, we feel we are undergoing the results. But when we look to our real nature, it is not, it is asanga by nature. So, karma bir nalipyate. So whatever karma is done by the subtle body, but Atman is not attached to that. Kinchid upadhi na krutai. Whatever the upadhis are doing karma, whatever is taken in place of Atman, that is doing the karma. So the result also is experienced by that. Result is not experienced by the Atman itself. Atman is asanga by nature. So through the dream, we can recognize this. What we are doing in the dream does not give us any fruit in the waking state. From this we understand that the Atman is only pure witness. It does not undergo any change. Only through the upadhis karmas are done. Through upadhis only it will reap the fruit. Atman itself is untouched. That we see through its function in the dream state. So here the discrimination becomes clearer through the dream state, that their impressions are there, but not the results thereof. By that we understand that Atman passes through these states, and the states are there because of wrong identification, and that which is wrongly identified will bear the fruit. Atman itself is asanga. It will not have any attachment or any fruit. Sarva vyapruti karanam lingam idam syat chidatmana punsa vasya adikam iva takshnai tenai vatma bhavati asangoyam. So again, the asangata or unattached nature of the Atman is found in this way. Atmana, punsa atmana, of a person, the real nature, chidatmana, is of the nature of consciousness. Through this subtle body, the linga sharira, it is engaged in all the activities. So, sarva vyapruti karanam. Whatever activities are being done through the linga sharira, so it is pervading. That linga, through the linga sharira, it becomes permeating or pervading all the activities. By its nature, it is consciousness. Example, there is a carpenter, Dakshina. Dakshina is a carpenter. Vasya, the chisel. Chisel and other instruments, Adi, of a carpenter. So through those instruments, he is doing the work. He is not involved. Like that, example of this, to understand that through the instrumentality of this separate body actions are being done, how Atman becomes involved only through Upadhi, not independently. Enaiva Atma Bhavati Asanga Vayam. So in this way only we can understand that Atma is unattached. Atma by itself is not doing any work, so it will become attached. Atma through the subtle body is doing work, so Atma through the subtle body will reap their fruit. Atma through the subtle body will become attached. Atma itself is consciousness. It has no physical dimension. It never gets attached. So discrimination with subtle body is being pointed out through the dream state and the functions of the subtle body. It is becoming clearer and clearer that whatever we do, whatever we experience, is not by the Atman itself. It is through the wrong identification with the subtle body that the actions are being performed, experiences are being gathered. Atman is absolutely unattached. Some more experiences directly being described. Andhatva, mandatva, patutva, dharma, saugunya, vaigunya, vashadi, chakshusha, badirya, mukhatva, mukhastathaiva, shrotra, adidharma, natu vettur, atmana. Atmana is the knower. Now, some people are blind. Atman is not blind. The instrument which is used for seeing is not functioning. Mandatva, some have very less power of sight. Patutva, some are experts through their eyes. All these dharmas, all these qualities, the good or bad, saugunya, vaigunya, vashadi, chakshusha, are due to the good or bad position of the eyes, not Atman. Atman is consciousness. The experience gathers through the instrumentality. If the instruments are bad, the experiences become like that, not Atman. Atman is only consciousness. Similarly, take the other instrument, ears. Deaf people are dumb because they have not heard the sound. So how to produce the sound, they do not know. So badirya means not hearing. Mukhatva means numbness. Mukha means they are the main. Like that, weakness of hearing, hard of hearing, slow speaking, all that thing. Tathaiva, in the same way as the we have seen about the eyes, shrotra di dharma belong to our ears. Our ears become defective, so our speaking also becomes affected. They do not belong to the Atman, which is the knower in all these things. Knower is not my ear. Atman is the knower through the ear. If the ear is not functioning properly, that functioning is not well. Nothing has happened to the Atman. So these experiences, external experiences in the relative world, are due to the organs, and they may be good or bad, but that does not touch the Atman. So discrimination is told in this way. Uchvasa nishvasa vijrumbhanakshu प्रस्यन्दनादि उत्क्रमणादि का क्रिया प्राणादि कर्माणि वदन्ति तज्ञा प्राणस्य धर्मो अशना पिपासे। उच्छ्वास इनहेलिंग, निश्वास थ्रोइंग आउट, विजृंभण योनिंग, विजृंभण श्रुति इज नॉट हंगर हियर, श्रुति स्नीजिंग, प्रस्यंदन स्वेटिंग और एनी सीक्रेशन आदि एंड उत्क्रमण आदि का क्रिया। वी हैव सीन दैट द उदान वायु इज द फंक्शन ऑफ टेकिंग अवे अवर सेटल बॉडी टू द अदर बॉडी। Tadnyaha, the experts in that field, the rishis, the yogis, vadanti, they say that it is the prana karma. The prana which has five types of functions, these are all prana karmas. Pranasya karmani, pranasya dharma. So, all the prana karmas are the characteristics of the prana. Main is the hunger and thirst. Hunger and thirst do not belong to the Atman. So a man of realization, he is beyond hunger and thirst. Important thing you have to understand, I remember an incident in my guru's life. I think I have narrated it. Let me narrate it again. The reading was going on. The person who was in charge of giving food to my Guruji came. He had finished his food. But because the reading was going on, his giving the food was delayed. So he's reminding my Guruji again and again, it is getting late, it is getting late. He said that if you are tired, you go and sleep. And he could have done that. But there was the responsibility of who will give food. So he said, in that case, who will give food? And spontaneously, my Maharaj replied, if somebody gives, I will eat. If somebody does not give, I will not eat. And he uttered the Bengali proverb, Shaligramer Basha Shoye Saman. In the temple, in the night, we give Shayana to the images. We make it slanting. Shaligram is same from all sides. So that we sitting or sleeping is same. This is a proverb to tell that the Brahman is not touched by his hunger or thirst. Important thing. So he says, this proves, only life proves what is Atman. So, pranasya dharma vashana pipase, hunger and thirst belong to prana dharma. And that are prana karmas, and they belong to prana's characteristics. But what is happening? Antakkaranam eteshu chakshuradishu varshmani aham iti abhimanena tishtati abhasa tejasa. Antakkarana, our inner organ, man, buddhi, chitta, ankara have been described. Chakshuradishu varshmani. Our indriyas have the citadel or location in the eyes, etc. We have seen that. And there the abhiman is born, I am that. I am what my eyes are, I am what my mind is, I am seeing, I am this. This is all due to superimposition or wrong identification with the indriyas and the antakkarana. But where from it gets light? Abhasa tejasa, Atman's reflected light. Atman's reflected light, abhasa, that is the light by which this I so and so, I enjoy, I am this, comes the light necessary for that is the reflected light of the Atman, not the Atman itself, not the Atman's light, but a reflection light comes, and we feel this is mine, this is mine. So this is how the indiscrimination is going on, and this is how discrimination will save us or separate our real nature from this trash which is not ourself. So understand now, what is ego? Amitya vimanena, that is ego. Ahankara sa vigyaya karta bhokta vimanayam sattvadi guna yogena cha vasthatre masnute. So know it to be mana buddhi chitta ahankar. Out of that ahankar has to be understood. So vidneya, you have to know, realize that this is ahankar, which is the doer and the enjoyer. I means my reality is neither doer nor enjoyer. But this ahankar, this wrong identification with the instrumentality, calling them as I or mine, that becomes responsible for doership and experiencerness. Karta bhokta abhimani ayam. Abhimani means I am that. This comes in the ego. This comes in the ahankar. Ahankara is wrong identification with the body and the indriyas and the mind, due to which that I am the doer and I am the experiencer comes. And waking, dream and deep sleep, all they belong to this ahankar. Sattvadi guna yogena cha avastha trayam ashnute. Sattva-raja-tama, the predominance of one or the other, by this he experiences the waking, the dream and the deep sleep. Simply the change of sattva-raja-tama, within that wrong identification, Atman is untouched. Atman is untouched by sattva-raja-tama, Atman is untouched by ahankar, Atman is untouched by the three states. All they belong to the wrong identification. So discrimination will save the Atman. From there, what pleasure and pain, how they come? Vishayanam anukulye sukhi dukhi vipare sukham dukham cha tad dharma sadanandasya natmana. If the vishaya, if the object is favorable, we can never define what it is favorable. In a hot climate, steam is not favorable. In cold climate, steam is favorable. In cold climate, ice is not favorable. In hot climate, ice is favorable. So it is a subjective quantity called anukulya. If it is anukul, then pleasure comes. Viparya, if it is not suitable, then dukkha comes. So sukha dukkha is the dharma of that mind. Sukha dukkha is the dharma of that mind. It is the mind which feels anukul or pratikul. The ego playing in through the antakarna feels I am happy, I am miserable. Sadanandasyana atmana. The nature of Atman is bliss. This is an important point in the study of Vedanta, which is not available in Sankhya, Nyaya, etc. They do not speak of that bliss. They only say absence of misery. But Atman, the nature is Sadananda. And it can be seen in person. How to say that Atman or Brahman are Ananda Swarup? Shankara has described in his commentary on Taittiriya Upanishad that whatever an ordinary person uses to give pleasure, none of them are present with the Brahmajna and yet he is happy. We have seen Brahmajna as happy without any accessory required for happiness. So the happiness is coming from their own real nature, Atman or Brahman. About Sri Ramakrishna, Holy Mother has said two things. Like him, Sadananda Purusha I have not seen. And I have never seen him Nirananda. with elderly people, with children, with young people, without anybody in samadhi, every time is happy. So Sadananda is the very nature of Atman. These sukha-dukhas are in the mind. And so they do not belong to the mind. Atman, that is the discrimination. If we can discriminate and come out of this identification with sukha and dukkha, we are free, we are Sadananda. Whatever happens is happening to the antakarana, not to me. Atmarthatvena hi prayan vishayona sata priyaha. Svata evai sarvesham atma priyatamo yataha tata atma sadanando nasya dukkham kadachana. Brihadaranyaka Upanishad is being referred to. There is an object in the Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, wife for the husband, husband for the wife. They are not the source of the joy. But the Atman, the reality of both is the same. And that is the source of the joy. So, the wife, Brihadaranyaka tells us, wife appears dear to the Atman, not because of the wife, but because of the common Atman. Husband appears dear to the wife, not because of the husband, but because of the common Atman. So, what is dear Atman? This very thing is described in the Brihadaranyaka in 148, that how to think of the Atman, it is the dearest. Dear than wealth, dear than son, this one must understand. Due to the wrong identification, the son becomes dear. I cannot think without my son. I cannot think without my daughter. This is due to wrong identification. If one can discriminate, Atman is Sadananda. It has nothing to do with son and daughter. So, the dearness element in wealth, the dearness element in son and daughter, or husband and wife, is due to Atman. Atmarthatvena, it is for the sake of the Atman, he vishayan. Objects are dear, appear dear. Na svata priya. By themselves, they are not dear. Mango, rasgulla are not dear for themselves. The joy comes from our tongue because Atman is Sadananda. They become only the occasions for that joy. So, the yogis can find all that joy in himself. Svata eva hi sarvesham atma priyatamo yata, because priyatama, the most dear of all, is only the Atman. Our own real nature, which is Satchit and Ananda, because of that Ananda Swarup, that is dear to us. That reflects here and there, and it appears that this thing is dear and that thing is dear. Beautiful discrimination is being taught here. Tata atma sadanando. So we understand that Atman is Sadananda. Nasya dukkham kadachana. It is untouched by any misery if one discriminates. If one can discriminate, it will never come in touch with misery because it is Sadananda by nature. So through the discrimination with the subtle body, which enjoys or suffers, it is being taught that if we can discriminate, we'll find Atman is bliss by nature. So there is no question of now and then. Always blissful. And we see this in all the Mahapurushas. They are always happy. Example, how to understand. Another way to understand that Atman has its own happiness. Yat sushuptau nirvishaye atma nando anubhuyate shruti pratyaksha maitiyam anumanam cha jagrati. Yet that sushuptau, in deep sleep, there is no object nirvishaye. and yet we experience the bliss. What is the bliss? Atmananda reflecting on a non-working mind. Indriyas are not working, mind is not working. On that non-working mind, the bliss of the Atman reflects, and that we enjoy in deep sleep. You give all sorts of enjoyment to a man. You are free to enjoy, but don't sleep for 1 week. That man will become mad. The highest joy experienced in the world is in deep sleep. But we cannot have deep sleep forever because the subject-object consciousness, as soon as the indriyas, our mind become fresh, again we come back to the same state. But it shows that the Atman is Sadananda because there are no objects to give us pleasure. One example I have given of the Parmanya Purusha. For our daily experience, we have to understand that in Sushupti, no object, and we experience happiness. This Shruti is telling us, directly we can experience. We can experience through what has happened in Aitya, Anumanam, by deductive logic we can understand. So, by Shruti, by Pratyaksha, by old history and by Anuman, we can understand that it is the bliss of the Atman which you experience in deep sleep. So, up till this point, the discrimination with subtle body is being explained, and through that discrimination, the real nature of Atman is being pointed out. It is consciousness only was pointed out, so light comes from the Atman. It is bliss is being pointed out because the joy comes from there. It is existence because of which all this superimposition takes place. So the real nature of Atman is being pointed out through discrimination with the subtle body mainly, through the gross body we already seen. So the topic of the subtle body, which was started in 92, it completes itself in 107. What remains now? The basic ignorance. The basic ignorance, which is the cause of all this. The basic wrong knowledge, which is the cause of the subtle body, which is the cause of identification with the subtle body, which is the cause of the existence of the subtle body, which is the cause of identification with the gross body, which is the cause of existence of the gross body. So that inscrutable wrong knowledge is the next topic of discrimination. Avyakta namni paramesha shakti anadi avidya trigunatmika para karyanumeya sudhiyaiva maya yaya jagat sarvamidam prasuyate maya sudhiyaiva. Those who have a good brain, those who have a good mind, those who have purer mind only can understand, can infer anumeya. Through inference, the good people can infer karyanumeya, seeing the results. Maya is not seen, never seen. The Shweta Shatra tells us, Devatma Shakti Sogunir Nivuda, hidden. But it can be inferred from its results. I think better take it next term. From here, when topic is over, the next topic is starting. So you can take this on the next term, though we read it today. We shall see it in detail in the next term. Om Sarva Vedanta Siddhanta Gocharam Tamagocharam Govindam Paramanandam सद्गुरुं प्रणतोऽस्म्यहम्। ओम शांति शांति शांति। हरि ओम तत्सत्। श्री रामकृष्णार्पणमस्तु।